another exciting video. I hope you'll enjoy this. I hope you think it's exciting. But today, let me show you first what I've got. I don't know if you can see full canvas or not, but if you can see, it's two blues, two different kinds of blues. I'm going to have this as the sky and this is the water. And I've got a little cabin kind of drawn out here and a little sailboat out here, and I'm just going to put some different things with it as we go along. And I'm going to show you my palette that I've got. And I've got some titanium white, cadmium red medium, cadmium yellow, yellow ochre, burnt umber. And this is a like a moss green. And this is a cobalt blue, ultramarine blue, cerulean blue, and a violet hue. Cobalt violet hue. So I hope you can see these. You won't be able to see. I'll try to show every once in a while my my palette here that I use. And again, this is a glass palette on a just a regular cardboard canvas, and I just taped it around with painter's tape so it won't get cut on the glass. And this is a glass that I took out of a photo frame. So that's how I use, and it's so easy to scrape off. And these are all, sorry if I didn't tell you, these are all done in oil. So I'm doing oil painting here today. And I'm using a turp as my medium. So let's get started. Okay. You notice this is a different setting. I'm up here in Tennessee, in Nashville, Tennessee, at my daughter's house. She's on an extended vacation. And I am actually babysitting the dogs. And that video I was just trying to show you, that I don't know if you can see it in the clouds, but there was a helicopter coming in. And Alan Jackson lives right pretty much three doors up where my daughter lives. So it's kind of cool watching him fly in and out. So, but anyway, let's get started on this painting. And I told you before, I've got some little birds already drawn up here. But I need to paint my clouds, put some clouds in here. And so my brushes, I've got different kinds of brushes, and I'll try to tell you what each one of them is as we go along. So, I'm going to start off today with my my filbert, a little round filbert. It's a 5-inch filbert, as you can see. Got a fan going here because it's pretty hot up here in Tennessee at the moment. I'm going to take just a little bit of my titanium white and I think I will add just a little bit of I want to make a gray mixture, and I'm going to take a little bit of the brown, and the warm colors here, and maybe a little of the blue if I can. It's kind of a pretty cool looking gray color, so. I'm mixing with this white here. Just a little more white here, a little dark. Try to just get the tip into my paint here, so I won't mess up the other paint. So now let's see how that turned down to a beautiful gray color here. So I'm going to clean my brush out because I don't want to use that color yet. I'm just wiping it on my paper towel here. A little medium on my brush, and I'll go straight into that titanium white. It's just got barely a pinch on it, so I'm going to kind of make a huge cloud here. I'm it's okay if I go over these birds, and there's two birds here that I'm getting ready to go over, because, you know, I can put it back in. No problem. Sorry, bird, gotta go over you. I'm gonna put just as much as I can on this and make it a little more wider. But I can always go back over it up here at the top. As we go further back, they get smaller and smaller, so, as we go down rather, so I want to kind of emphasize that here. And it doesn't matter, I'm just kind of putting random. They get smaller and smaller, like I said, as we get out. And we have some little bitty ones back here. And you get longer. So I just don't get to show where my clouds are going to be right now. So. I'm going to scratch the ones up in here. Just a little bit of yellow to this skin. So just brighten up that top just a little bit and this side over here. A little bit and kind of portray like the sun, the light is more in here than anywhere else. You notice I'm just doing it on that edge right there. A little bit. Just where the sun might be showing on it, a little bit there. Now your neck gray. Put just a tiny pinch in it. You have dimensions here of color, so. If you'll see here how I've done that gray, I've got a little darker here. So this pretty much is a little lighter than that one, and then this is lighter. And if you get further down, you want it to be darker, so darker at the bottom. mine. Simply Simmons. Take my Simply Simmons brush here, and I'm just going to kind of go up. Fluff up the clouds just a little bit. In circular motion like this. On top of each one. Hang that, and then I'm going to go over. Very lightly. Very lightly. My water has to be completely flat. If I know this is pretty flat, I'll put over these clouds and put some more white into them. Some pure white into them and brighten them up quite a bit. Make this my center point, whitest area here. Was it blended well enough? Yeah. Okay, before I head in, this roof is going to be a try to do, I don't know if you've ever seen this technique done before. I put a, I don't know what this is going to look like, so this is my first time doing this. Paint that I'm using is not a very good paint to me. I mean, but what I did was, anyway, enough of that. I put a little yellow ochre on one side and a little burnt umber on the other. And I'm just going to make little highlights. But I want the yellow umber to be the ochre to be on the top. Now, burnt umber. Just tapping my brush. It looks like there's a little shingle. Okra and okra. Okra's always on top. And the reason we want the okra on top, it'll look like the sun. Oops, sorry. The sun is hitting it, and this fan's blowing my hair in my mouth. I'm so sorry, guys. Now watch out for that chimney coming out of the door. I hope you're able to see this as it comes out. There's a little skylight here in this. Little skylight at the top. Trying to stay away from that. I'm always having a problem with saying okra, because I always want to call it Indian from the South, and my favorite thing is okra, that you eat. So I'm always having a hard time pronouncing that. I know it's okra, but you'll hear me sometimes say okra, and I'm so sorry for that. You know me. Born and raised in the South, can't help it. There's another little window right here. I'm coming on it, and I'm trying to avoid that also. I'm skipping that. Edge of the roof. I'm going to go back over now to where I go. The blue showing through. And just kind of put a definition, defining point of this roof. I'm going to take this straight black umber. If you'll notice, this is coming down through here. This is the chimney. And you've got a shadow up here. Up just a little bit and down. Now on this, I'm going to take more of a contour brush here, and I'm going to go to a very small brush. I'm traveling. I didn't have it in a secure enough case. But what I did was I took a little burnt umber and a little of the cadmium red just to brighten it up just a little bit. So this is the back side that I'm doing now of the chimney. Go with a lighten it up just a little bit with a little yellow. highlighting. Brush. And I'm going to take some of this white and kind of smear it across here like this. Make sure these are windows. Focus more into this area here, and then I'll back off the camera. So you can see where I've done quite a bit of the detailing on this. My canvas, my palette. Now I'm going to do this. I'm kind of going to streak this down, and I'll show you how to do that. I'm taking my 6-inch brush. Now this is a synthetic brush. Today. Now I'm going to have to define and keep my very flat 10-inch here, and I'm going to go into a darker. I'm going to put my really dark mixture. All almost a black. And what I'm doing is taking her number and that moss green and then that cobalt blue. And that optic a little bit off. I'm just barely taking almost a brush. I'm just going to go scoot it down. Find the heat edge. Darker. See where that torch comes from. I think it's going to have to be a little darker than that. Alright, I see a quite good. Like it's pain. Pain to God. This side a little lighter over here. It's getting more sun in the other part. Thank you. lighter color.
This is a new camera that I'm using now. It's just a standby when my other one dies, like it just did. So, anyway, hope this one's going to work. I don't know. But we'll try. If not, there'll be a segment of this art show that, you know, we'll have to play it by ear and see what happens. So, anyway, I think it's coming along really, really good. And I hope you are enjoying it. I'm going to go ahead and start putting in the detail of the little boat here because I'm pretty much running out of... I'm putting too much of the oil in it right now, and I really don't want any blue in it because it will definitely distort my my white. I want my white to be pretty pure if I can keep it that way. So. Maybe we won't have to use this camera too long here. Add a little medium to that. And I'm just going to grace my hand here. And right now what I'm doing is just drawing. I'm just doing the outline of this, and I'm a little shaky, so I'm going to try my best to straighten that up. I did not bring my mall stick with me, and I'm having to use my hand as a prop. Yes, I want that Zelda kind of bow a little bit, but not so much. And notice how I'm coming away. When I'm coming down through this thing, I want it to kind of like, looks like it's kind of bowed just a little bit. So the cell is going to kind of be, look like it's bowed also. To draw it out freehand. I'm sorry I don't have a way for you to do that, but you know, it doesn't have to be just this sailboat. It can be any kind of sailboat. So, you know, just anything you want. Any kind of boat you want out here on the water. Moving into my my medium over here, so. And what I said, I'd like to come away from it. I'm just kind of flicking it, so it'd be, looks like it's billowing cell. Little that little kind of like a little rope hanging down from there. And then I'm going to go into that a little gray here. And I just went back into that old mixture, that different colors that I had. And I'm just going to make a try to get this rigger line down this here. And it's real soupy too, because you gotta have it soupy or the brush will split on you. And I'm gonna make this a I think I will have that brush. And I think I'll make that boat a pretty, like a pretty yellow kind of. And I want it to kind of be dark. Bit more of that dark blue. So anyway, this is where I've got to so far, and what I did was I just added, this is going to be the sand, and I'm starting to add the little, just some little bushes and things like that that's in the sand, and maybe this is just like a little path going down through there or something like that, but anyway, I know that a lot of video was lost there because of my camera just, like I said, this is a new camera. I don't think it wants to work with me right now, but anyway, I think I'll put some little sand dunes up here, and some little grasses up here, and I'm just taking my brush and flicking it.
I'll add a little bit more darker cobalt blue to that because it's not going to show up in this house unless I do.
but you can see I've added just a lot of different colors to my waters, because I love to incorporate these different colors in my water. This painting, I hope you enjoyed it. I think I'll go now. What I'll do is paint the sides of it and add a little bit more highlight to these things. Cloudy cells, is that you, as we all know, cells are not all colored white. Get leathered a little bit. So. Just adding some, just a tint of brown to it that's got, that is kind of muddied up my white. So. Here we go, on that. And I think I'll add a little darkness to the front here. My sailboat. Maybe a little bit up here to show these clouds. But you want to brighten this up. I mean, as you can see, it gets pretty dark, so you do want to brighten this up as much as you can. This painting. And just go over it, whatever you can see, you know, fix it. I hope you've enjoyed this painting. I have certainly enjoyed painting it. Stay tuned and we'll do another one. Just keep watching my videos and we'll do some more. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.